To make sure that your ass is behaving properly. That's why.
Yeah. Behave your ass. Alright, we live.
Live. Oh, snaps. We're in there. Oh, goodness gracious. It's been so long. So what are we doing? What are we doing, guys? We're gonna play some of this.
We're gonna set an agenda. And then
we're gonna follow.
Then we're gonna follow it.
That's what we're gonna do.
We're gonna team ladder. What is this?
So I just made that announcement post, right? So we got.
Are you gonna make an announcement post that we're live right now?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Okay.
I mean, I can, and then we all
share. Oh god! Facebook, why you do this? It's just.
What?
Not cooperating. Publish. Oh my god, I need to just like mute this music real quick.
Yeah, just do that.
Cause it's fucking killing me. Oh, that was everything. I muted everything.
Man, some people going crazy, so man. Have you seen this nonsense? People are like taking long, you know, like the long socks when they go to public bathrooms and sliding them over the rims of the toilet. Instead of like using the toilet paper and rough, they're putting the socks around the toilet.
Not like this.
What is this nonsense?
You know, you know, it'd be like way better. If you, instead of doing that, you know, donated those nice socks to a homeless person. Like, you could feel good about yourself and not waste socks.
Man, that plan sucks.
Wow.
Don't kick me.
God. Let's see, I want to see what happens if I, like, move you guys. That change anything?
Whoa!
Alright, excellent. So it actually is within the window, so I can move the window around and shit. That's awesome. Cool. So, did Jacquez die? Like,
I'm right here, guys.
I'm put his head down. Oh, you texting or something? Okay.
I see a complete white hood.
Looking at the announcement post.
Oh, got it, okay.
I was reading the announcement post and I'm about to share this post.
Got it.
Make sure you like it. Or don't. I can't stop you. Or don't. I can't stop you.
Alright, I'm not dead. I swear. Alright.
Did I successfully mod you?
Oh.
No, I don't have permission to mod you, apparently, in the chat.
You're logged in as,
as myself, not as.
Actually, I should be able to, because. I thought I was,
Let me open the stream so I can see the chat.
Oh boy.
Oh, thank goodness. Yay. We stream it. Oh man. Look at this. We're all on webcams. Oh. It's so gold.
Yeah. Brian hasn't changed his picture to a picture of him or the BFG logo yet.
Brian.
Or is it just not updated?
Brian, come back.
Yeah, I think he ran away.
Brian was like, you. Why
did I have to? No, I did that like 10 minutes ago.
Oh.
Did you?
Okay. Well, I'm gonna kick you off with a call, and then you're gonna rejoin.
Oh. Brian's beautiful just the way he is.
Not like this.
Persecution.
Boogers, it didn't update. Well, whatever. He's Naruto
boogers.
Tonight.
All right.
He's Naruto tonight.
Yeah, didn't.
He's Naruto every night.
Naruto boys. We anime now.
We anime now.
Jeez. And you guys gotta watch more fighting games. Come on now.
For real. I wish I liked watching fighting games, for real. Like, they seem like a lot of fun.
I wish you did too. That's why we got on ESPN and stuff, man. It was pretty cool. Evo was lit. I didn't get to go this year. I'm kind of jealous, but they got to be on ESPN2, and it was
amazing. Watching them at the bar, actually.
Was it on at the bar?
Yeah,
what?
For real.
Oh, that's legit.
Does my thing look better now?
Yeah, but I need to fix you. There we go. Whatever.
God made me perfect. You can't fix me. I'm not broken.
Check out how you look on stream.
Dude, I'm the hottest member of the team.
Yeah.
Look how symmetrical I am.
How symmetrical you is that what we do now?
I mean,
that's
symmetry
what it
is beauty.
That's what it
is. I guess that is. I guess that. I don't think so, man. Because some people look weird as hell if their faces were like completely symmetrical. That would be weird.
I've got a broken nose, so you know.
I mean, my nose is all kinds of not right.
Tim's nose isn't broken, but it looks like it is.
Yeah, it's.
Brian, why?
I guess I could show you guys. It's definitely diagonal.
The high definition.
High definition diagonal nose.
But you have a gorgeous girlfriend anyway, so it doesn't matter. Your face is symmetrical enough to do what it needs to do. So shut up.
You're
well,
too nice.
I mean, when you were talking about how he got his girlfriend, I thought you were gonna say his tongue was symmetrical enough to get his. I'm glad no one's watching right now.
Nah,
that one was bad.
I know, see. It's like a few people there.
It's me and Brian right now.
No, it's not. It's six people right now. What are you talking about?
Oh, shit.
Yeah. What are you guys talking about?
Are you able to hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, what's up, Matt? How you doing, man?
Looking good. Good, yeah. I like your camera, Tim. You look high def.
I know.
You want to say that to my face?
Oh, because you are!
Got me.
Okay. I need to readjust these. And
these nuts.
Don't worry, everyone. We will get to Hearthstone soon. Well, we're still talking about Hearthstone, though. How about we? You can talk more about how you don't like the Big Bad Wolf card, because I feel like controversial opinions are
okay,
the best.
Okay. After talking with Tim, I still am not convinced. But
dang! How do you do this?
It could possibly get better over time. Like, I don't know.
Do you know who he is? He's Tim from Tim's team.
Timothy from Timothy's team.
That is true. He is Tim from Tim's team, and I gotta put some respect on it. I gotta put some respect on the name. But
And 100% reason to remember the name.
Wow.
Man, I haven't heard that song in a while. Goodness gracious.
I don't know. Oh. That song was so bad.
That song was so good. You're a hater.
I am a hater. For real. For real, I'm a hater.
It's been fun, guys.
We lost three people because of that one comment. Oh, your mom.
We did.
You're killing the stream. With your shitty six music.
Oh, no.
Oh, you monster. How could you?
Alright, check this shit out. Bam. Alright, now, tell me that that's not legit.
Wait, something happened?
Yeah, the stream. Everybody's got their pictures. All good to go.
Alright, so, agenda, my friends.
Yeah. So, agenda. Let me open some Google Doc.
My agenda, we're going to build a wall. It's going to be a beautiful wall. Build a nice, giant...
Okay, how big is it going to be?
It's gonna be huge. It's gonna be enormous. It's gonna be this big.
It's gonna be huge.
Wall. You know, it's gonna be huge. It's gonna be big. It's gonna be a huge wall. Man. So kindly, Grandma is. That's the next meta move right there for Hunters, huh? That's what we're doing.
It's unfortunate, but yeah.
That's the next meta move out here. Mm-hmm. We couldn't get like, you know, two drop, two, three, I don't know, man.
Gives you all the more reason to run abusive sergeants and direwolves.
Give us like a two drop, you know, maybe like a 2-3 or 3-2 discover beast, you know.
I think it's a fantastic hybrid aggro card.
Kindly Grandma?
Yeah.
I think it's good for. I think it would be good for aggro, just for the fact that like, it's gonna be consistently doing damage until it's removed, and that means they're gonna be using resources like, on turn two. There's no way for you to remove that card. I'm just trying. Wait, no. Shaman can, I guess, but yeah. I don't know, I just don't like it for mid-range. It just doesn't feel good. I feel like what I need. I need some draw mechanics, bitch!
Oh, God.
We really do.
We got a new follower! Thank you, DOG Tony!
Oh, man, we in there.
Hey. He's the best.
Why?
Why? Is that gonna be our, like, follower tagline?
It is.
Yeah, everybody just like has that thing that like, welcome to the broskies or whatever. That should be ours. Like, welcome to our channel, you're the best.
And then we just actually have the Red Hot Chili Peppers song.
Wait, what? Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Red Hot Chili Peppers, man, you know. Red Hot Chili
Peppers. Foo Fighters.
It's Red Hot Chili Peppers, man, come on. What are you talking about? I know it's the Foo Fighters, guys.
What?
Oh, man.
You terrify me.
Now, it also would have been acceptable to say play the Smash Mouth song over and over again.
Oh yeah, Ben Bro song.
One second,
followers
guys.
Keep coming. I'll be right back. Stop coming.
Okay.
Hey, Brandon.
Yeah?
I just noticed a flaw with the host setup.
What?
If we got some people in the Tom Locke Twitch channel and some people in the Blindfire Gaming Twitch channel. Uh-huh. We had two separate Twitch chats.
So that's fine.
We can rectify that at another time.
Yeah. I will That's fine. Alright. I'll be right back.
Okay. What's upstream? What's going on? Also, Poland got a big one. Yes, he did, sir.
Where the giant spider was. No, he like definitely huge. Got a big one. Like full on. Like same. AKA, yeah, same though we saw it.
You got promotion from unemployed to full time.
Yeah, no!
Have you guys been playing any new decks over the last week?
I've been rolling with them. Like Blood Warrior Warrior.
What kind of warrior? That.
So what?
What warrior did you say?
Blood Warrior Warrior. It's a tempo. I just made a tempo deck.
Oh, I forgot. I thought you were talking about Blood of the Ancient one. I was like, wait, what?
Okay,
but yeah.
Oh man, I wish that worked.
So what, do you just have a bunch of like little like ones and twos and threes and then you just like refill your hand and play them all again, or?
No. You place like standard tempo stuff, and you make like. But the thing is, it's kind of. I like Blood Warriors better than, Battle Rage, because it refills hands with things that I don't know what they are, so I can determine the value of my Blood Warrior as long as my main stay healthy enough for me to. Battle Rage, I just kind of draw cards and hope I get shit. But like I can get Malkorok. I can get Malkorok back, I can get Ragnaros' back, and it's just basically you manipulate. It's kind of like when people play Echo of Medivh. It's basically the same principle, but as a warrior.
Yeah.
And like, sometimes the tempo can just win you games. Go ahead.
I was Tim sent me a link to, I think it was like Elite, or Eloise's C'Thun Warlock, Reno Warlock. Dude, there's something like, it feels so bad. Like, just the C'Thun elements aren't consistent enough. There's only like four activators, and if you don't draw or anything, it's only, your C'Thun only gets up to like, generally like 15-15, which is not like anything to like dismiss, but it's not like as good a win condition as like C'Thun could be. I don't know, just the deck feels like a worse Reno lock. I think I'd rather play like Heads Up.
I'm gonna say, is C'Thun even actually considered a win condition? Isn't he normally used as like a control card late game?
Yeah, but it still doesn't, I don't know, it just, it hasn't really felt good. I don't know.
I understand.
You know what else hasn't felt good?
What?
Reno lock.
That's true. That's why I don't play this on ladder. I don't.
Hey, man. Kai's top 10, top 15 EU with Handlock. So Handlock is back, baby.
Like legit Handlock?
Handlock.
Do you have a copy of that list?
Yeah, I do.
Could you actually link it in the Twitch chat?
No, I screenshot it so I can send it to you guys.
Oh my gosh.
If you guys want to do some Imgur magic.
I do not know how to change the volume on the new follower alert noise.
My iPad. But yeah, no. The list looks legit. Like,
shit, I was on mute. I do not know how to change the volume on the new follower noise, but when I figure that out, I really need to, because it is very loud.
I think that volume is the best.
Thank you, Blue Marrell, for being the best.
What's up?
Because
I know that. I know.
Thanks
that
for
name.
The follow. Yeah, that's Eileen. Yeah.
Eileen. Oh, that's the homie right
Nerdtron.
There.
Nerdtron.
Yeah.
That's the homie right there.
No, Eileen. All right. Eileen is the homie.
Jeez. So okay, I need to.
She's on the other side, but I mean, you know.
I set the agenda.
Like other side of the pillow, on top of Mount Everest, homie. Like, yeah, this should work.
Okay.
I followed none of that, but I'll go with it.
I need to go to a URL shortener real quick.
Yeah, so you know what's up.
Google URL shortener.
You fucking winky wave at my homie. What the hell is wrong with you, Tim?
Can't even tell if that emote's winking.
Oh no.
Don't be hating on the leopard print blanket. It's nice and soft. I could wear the IPG blanket I got today, but you know.
Wait,
that doesn't seem very appropriate.
First and foremost, who's hating on the leopard print blanket? Listen, Eileen, this is right now, we're just trying to get everything under wraps, and then we're gonna get going. There's nothing to, absolutely nothing to spy on. Besides you getting early access to my new Battle.net name change. you get early access.
That's the real reward.
That is what this stream is all about. Because, okay, so since it was because of what's it called, Overwatch coming out, they gave us an extra free one. And King Fatalis is now Caramel Hulk. And it is the best name that I could have possibly wanted. So many people have added me that I played just to tell me my name is legit.
Because your name is legit.
That's amazing.
It's worthy of recognition. Oh, he's not playing double Demon Wrath.
Alright. Yeah, you got Chester the Cheetah in the back. Tim, can you show the crowd Chester the Cheetah real quick?
I don't have to do nothing.
You know? I'm actually...
Oh, yeah.
I'm gonna show everyone this real quick. There you go. Check out Chester the Cheetah. That is great.
And it's the flaming hot one. That's dope. Where did you even get that, bro?
It's a good story.
Tell a story about where I got it.
Yeah, it's a good story.
So, My sophomore year of high school, our color was orange, and we made a float for homecoming, and that was on the float. And I spent a lot of time helping out with that float, so one of our teachers asked if I wanted to take it home, and I said, hell yes. It's been on my wall for, 7 years now? 8 years?
Oh, man. Oh, yeah, that's legit. That is super legit. So,
it is worthy of recognition.
So, what did you think about the handlock list that I just sent you?
Well, it's cool. I'm surprised that there's not two Demon Rats in it.
Why would you play double Demon Rat in handlock?
I don't know.
Do you feel
I don't know. Handlock has evolved a long way.
I'm saying, do you feel it's necessary for, like, double... Because when that actually, like, mess up your matchup against Zoo, because then you have, like, two... kind of shit. I guess they don't have that many demons anymore, actually, now I think about it.
That's a fair point.
They don't really have that many demons anymore, any high-value demons, so, like, I guess it's not that bad. Like, it's not like you're just going to try and play demon... Like, you can't play Demon Wrath because the dude's just sitting there, and his board is, like, two Void Callers and, you know, some extra shit. So... and some imps he got from an implosion. Oh, by the way, I just want you guys to know. Oh, shoot. If this whole BFG thing don't work out, guys, we can just go. We can go be host in Japan. Just FYI. We're gonna go be host in Japan, man. Like, I saw this video of a dude. It was like years ago. Man said he made. Oh yeah, that is there's a new neutral demon, but that new neutral demon is gonna be butt cheeks. But yeah, man, dude said he made like 200k US in one night before.
Just by entertaining ladies.
Oh, so, yep. Mm-hmm.
Saw that.
I was like, oh.
Oh yeah, yeah. Tim, get that YouTube up in there, in that chat.
What? Tim, get what?
Put right. That Tim's Team YouTube link up in that chat.
Like, comment, and subscribe, please.
I'm not really...
Hey, yo, Silent... Oh, sorry, one sec. Silent Walrus is already a follower. I feel like he can get that. Alright, sorry, Jay. Go ahead.
So, I was going to ask you guys your opinion on, like, the new neutral demon and how you feel about him and his effects. I don't really like it. Personally, I think it's way too gimmicky.
Yeah, it's too expensive. If you've
are
got
we talking about
the 7/7?
Yeah, Malthazar.
Oh, never mind.
Oh, what are you talking about? What's 7/7?
I thought you were talking about the host, but that's not a demon. He's just like a dude.
You're talking about Medivh? That's
yeah.
Medivh, homie.
Yeah.
By the way, he's the first hero. He's the first hero to also be a card.
Oh, interesting. That's pretty cool. I saw that. What what's that tournament we were gonna play on Sunday? You want to link that one?
Yeah. Are we playing both the Saturday and the Sunday tournament, or are we just gonna pick one?
I have no problem playing against or playing or with anybody playing more than one
both.
Tournament. But
are you gonna play both?
This Sunday, I am playing. Next Sunday, I will not be available. So, yes.
Alright. Get a link for you.
Alright. Who can play against me and talk at the same time?
Me.
Alright, let's do it. Let's get that standard. Can I challenge you to a tavern brawl? I wonder.
Yeah.
You want
oh,
to
wait,
play?
No. You're right.
No, you can't tell them that, not today. Not this week's, because it's the Stormwind one.
Do you want me to put a link to on the doc?
Yes.
So.
Yeah. So anybody can go to that URL whenever you want.
Edit it.
Oh.
You better access
it. Yeah. I need to put your email address in.
No, you can just make a...
But I don't want anybody with a link to be able to edit, because...
Oh, right.
The link's
right.
Shared publicly.
So, yo, Matt.
What's up, man?
So what cards are like impressing you the most throughout this throughout what we've seen thus far? What are the most impressive cards for you so far?
Well, we haven't seen. I'm excited to see what they're gonna unveil for Priest. We haven't seen anything for that yet, but so far I really like Prince Malcazar, dude. Like, I know you guys aren't really on that hype train. Like, I just see it like fitting really well in a, like, Elise Priest. I think it's the first deck I'm gonna craft or create, and just use that as like. It's 28 removal cards. You create like a really awesome foundation, and then you have these really, ideally like powerful, cards coupled with like Elise. I think it's like, I'm excited for it. I don't think it's gonna be like a mid-range card. I think it's just gonna be like a
control card.
Yeah, I think, you know, it opens up like deck building. It's basically four extra slots in your deck.
So if you think it opens up deck building, like how would you account for the randomness factor of the card though? Because, you know, you could get anything from like Lorewalker Chose to Nefarians and stuff like that. So I don't. So where, I guess, how would the deck building aspect come into that? I guess.
I mean, it's just like what you would just build like your standard, like whatever you would just put like take the Elise Priest shove, where it's basically like you might run like Enzoth, you know, kind of your like grinder priest, like take out one card, like maybe an Excavated Evil or maybe not Evil, but like Darkshire Alchemist, put Prince Malcazar in there, and
isn't Darkshire Alchemist like the 4/5 that heals?
Yeah, it's kind of like underwhelming half the time. Like.
Is it really? What about a Cult Apothecary or whatever the heck it is? I don't know. What is that?
The 5 mana 4/4 that heals?
Based on your opponent's minion count.
That card's just controversial to begin with. Like, that card does nothing.
I don't know, man, because people play it in, what's it called, Arena Lock, and that's what people have been playing lately in Arena Lock. They've been doing pretty okay.
I suppose. It's more of a stall card. Like,
that's fair. That's fair. But, like, isn't it two... What is it? Two for each minion?
Yeah, I think so.
I think it's like two for each minion. So, I think it's actually pretty decent. Like, I like it against aggro decks, but of course it's bad against control decks. And I think that's the trade-off, though.
I'm also really excited for Angry Blades. I just love that card design.
Oh, dude, yeah, that card design is so awesome.
Angry Blades. Is that what it's actually called? Angry... No, no, the like Angry Kara Dishes. Kazan.
Karazan? Something, I don't know.
Karazam. Yeah, Karazam. Like, you know. And it's actually pretty cool. I'm really happy for it, too. It reminds me of Beauty and the Beast, because that's where they drew a lot of the inspiration for that one from. So, I'm really looking forward to it. I really hope that, man, honestly, I'm looking forward to the bosses, because just seeing the Dish Golem or whatever, it was pretty cool. The Silver War Golem or whatever it was, that fight was pretty dope. So, if I'm looking forward to any card so far, it's, man, probably, I don't even really play Warlock, but yeah, Karazam is really that card is really cool, and I think it's really nice that they finally gave Warlock like an army in a can card that is not gonna die to any like whirlwind AoE. It's not just gonna get wrecked by Warrior and, you know, Ravaging Ghoul. Because in all honesty, I think that card is ridiculously strong. They're like, you can't have Death Bite and stuff anymore, but here, have this 3/3 that's like, have this 3/3 that drops a whirlwind effect anyway. That's compensation enough, right, guys? But then Warlock loses like Dark Bomb, and there's no replacement for that early game removal for control Warlocks. Like, you better put that Doomsday in your deck and shut the hell up. Like, that's just kind of what happened.
Put that Doomsayer in your deck.
Oh man, we were talking about that. I'm so excited. I really want to try that deck. Oh my god, it seems like it's gonna be fun. If it's not good, it still will be fun. And if it is good, I think it'll be complicated to play though.
I think it's gonna be like super freaking fast though. Like, I think a lot of it's gonna be in your mulligan, and like you have to really, I don't know.
I agree. Man, We gotta wait and see what other cards come out, I guess. But I'm really excited to see that they're actually going somewhere with that, because the librarian was really the Darkshire librarian. She was really just underwhelming with her effect. But like now, if you get that Malthazar's Imp or whatever it is, you get that out. She lets you like draw two cards. When she gets played and throws one away, and then one when she dies, because she lets you draw a card back when she dies. And it seems like there's going to be a lot of value to be found in that discard warlock play style.
So, well, is a 3/2 body unfair enough to be considered like worth having like a discard over? Like, you know, the whole point of discard is like you're cheating basically. And yeah. I don't even know if that, like, does Darkstar Librarian make the cut? Like, I don't know if it does.
I mean, it's not. So the thing is, you are going to have other cards that do things when they get discarded. So
yeah, that's true.
Say you hit the Golem, you get a 3/2. You now have a 1/3, a 3/2, and a 3/3. Or you, I don't know if Fist of Draxus is gonna make it. But if you get Fist of Draxus, you know, it's a 1/3, a 3/2 that just dealt 4 damage, and it's going to draw you 2 cards. So I think that discard warlock isn't going to be about the individual pieces. It's going to be more about the synergy between those pieces. So I don't think that any one particular card is going to have like a immense amount of value. It's going to be when you play certain cards together that you're going to be able to get the potential of the deck. It's like you're trying to combo like most, like the whole, it's like you're trying to combo like the whole game from start to finish.
What kind of minions do you run? Do you run like Imp Gang? Is Imp Gang too slow?
I think you always play Imp Gang. I don't see a time when you don't play Imp Gang. That card is ridiculous. Like, that card is still so good. Only time it wasn't good was when Patron was around, and it was still good when Patron was around. So
when they first released like the discard, like when they first did Fist of Draxus, like I always tried to play that deck like super low curve, like every single like aggressive one drop, like trying to isolate like my discards, you know. Mm-hmm. And it seemed like that was the most viable way. Like when you try to like start playing like more of like a, I don't want to say like mid range, but like mid range in comparison to like an aggro zoo, like it felt like a little more inconsistent. So that's why, like, I wonder if like three drops outside of like your dish guy, I don't know. It seems like it's going to be a very hard deck to, I think, refine.
I think it's going to be a hard deck to refine, and I definitely think it's going to be a hard deck to play. But if it works, I think it's going to work really well. Like, I think that's just kind of what it is. It's going to be kind of like one of those decks like Patron. I don't know if it's going to be, I'm not saying it's the strongest Patron, but it's going to be one of those decks kind of like Patron in regards to when it works. When you play it and you understand it, it's going to work really well. But if you just are out there doing stupid stuff, you're not going to win anything. Like, yeah. It's going to take a lot of knowledge about the combos. And like you said, that isolation factor, that's actually a really good idea. Play those low drops so that you can manipulate what you're tossing away as much as possible, of course, because, you know, there's not going to, sometimes you're just not going to have the wiggle room to do some stuff. But, and what about, so what about like peddlers and stuff? Like, since cards are getting tossed away anyway, is peddler going to lose value?
No, I think you always run peddler. You want more slow fires, dude.
I think
peddler's just too good not to run.
That's fair.
I would run 4 peddlers in lieu of like 2 Imp Gang bosses, I think.
That's bold. That's strong right there. I love Imp Gang bosses, man. But you are the zoo. You are the warlock master. I'm not as good as Brandon.
I think Brandon's like the zoo master for sure.
I don't know. So would you do that, Brandon? Is the value from a Dark Peddler enough where you would replace your 2 Imp Gang bosses if you could with Peddler?
Peddler is certainly a better card in that deck, but like I would still look to cut a different card for sure. Like, yeah. Both those cards are incredible.
I just think that, I just thought that was interesting, man. That's really strong, because me personally, I think that, like, outside of, like, maybe Darkshire Councilman and the absolutely, what I feel is overrated, I mean, underrated at times, what is it called? Forbidden Tentacles? Like, I feel that card is so underrated by some people. Like, because people always want to play it when you can, you know, do it with knife juggers and stuff like that, but sometimes the right thing to do is just play it for board and
yeah.
just use it like it's Living Roots.
Oh, for sure. I mean, it's definitely, like, an oft-misevaluated card.
I think that that's one of the best cards in the deck. I love Imp Gang Boss a lot. And I feel like he contributes up to a lot of wins, because, like, you attack into something and then you get to drop a, you know, you attack into something, it lives. You defend a Vargas target, and now he's basically a 3/5, and then he just keeps escalating in value the more times he gets hit. And he forces your opponent to play certain ways. It can force your opponent not to make certain plays just because Imp Gang Boss is on the board. So that's why I really like Imp Gang Boss. But Peddler can do crazy stuff that you can make it to where you can't play around Peddler stuff. Like, how you play around 16 burst damage from hand because you got, because both your Peddlers gave you power overwhelming.
So. Yeah, I mean, that happens.
It does, and it makes me upset when it happens. See, that's why I'm so happy I have Call It an 8 to make things even. Call It an 8 is probably the best card in this set.
That is definitely possible.
How do you feel, Tim? What do you feel is the best card in this set? What are your guys' opinions on that?
In Old Gods?
Yeah, in Old Gods. What do you feel like? If you had to pick, like, a top three, and people were like, what's your top three cards for this set, what would it be?
Call of the Eight's up there. It's unfortunate that Hunter is in such a, like, strange spot that it didn't really... It felt like not enough, you know?
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. I mean, everyone fears Call of the Eight, and they fear turn six, but they don't really fear much other than that. So if you can beat Hunter before any of those happen, then you win. Which is why, you know, Aggro Shaman, Dragon Warrior... I mean, that's not directly why, but... I mean, those decks pass the aggro test, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I haven't really thought... I think Nuzoth's up there in terms of just how good a card is.
Okay, that's fair.
It gives control decks a, you know, turn 10 win condition.
That was awesome.
That's right. What about you, Matt? What would your top three for this set be?
Enza, for sure. I still think Cho'Gall has a lot of potential. I could see everybody bitching about him in 6 months or something. I don't know about my number three. Doomhammer?
Doomhammer got re-released from Old Gods. Reprints already.
Yeah, no, I don't know. That's tough.
If I had to pick three, I honestly think Call of the Wild would probably be number one. I just think that card is really, really strong. And I do feel like just from me playing alone, and I don't know if that's just because of how well I play, you know, like, because Hunter is my class. That's my main class. That's the class I started playing with. I also played a lot of Shaman. Those are my big two classes. But I have a very high win rate, and I feel like a lot of those games can be stolen because of Call of the Wild. Or, like, when you play two Call of the Wilds versus a control deck, what does that control deck do? You know? It just completely wins games, especially if you draw the second copy. It's like Hunter's version of anything can happen. If you hit both, there's next to no reason you don't win that game. Number two is honestly probably Ragnaros the Light Lord. That card is so damn good. I love that card so much. I think that Ragnaros the Light Lord is probably one of the most powerful cards in the set, because it does what Ragnaros does, but in a very different, but in a different way. It creates a tempo. It creates a card. It makes a card that, if not dealt with, your opponent's inevitably going to lose, except your opponent is not able to flood the board and able to make you and able to, you know, fuck up your chances of winning. He actually has to directly deal with that Ragnaros or else he is going to lose, period. And yeah, probably Enzoff, because Enzoff is ridiculous. Wait, no, sorry. Even after that long-ass explanation, Fandral. Fandral is actually number two. That card is ridiculous. But
yeah,
three is
I
definitely
agree with that.
Three is definitely Enzoff. Fandral is so good. Fandral just creates situations that no grown man should ever have to be put in.
Oh man.
What do I do besides cry when my opponent Raven Idols? He Raven Idols, he picks a spell, he picks a minion, and then I see him Raven Idol his Raven Idol and pick another spell and pick another minion. And then he hits me with an Innervate and a Nourish. I cry. That's the answer that you guys, I cry. Or like Rat, or like, you know, what is it? Call it or Power of the Wild, you know, you get a whole board full of bullshit, you know, buffs, and you get an extra minion. He just synergizes so well, and he creates such scary situations. You cannot leave him for a turn at all, otherwise you are probably going to be behind really bad.
Are you prepared to deal with this board? Yes, you are. Damn it.
Oh man, see that's the scary thing. It's like you have to do it. Like, you just, I hate Fandral. He just makes me. He fucks up like your whole turn. Like that's the thing is he makes you spend that mana. Out here having.
Don't 10 forget 10. About Fandral Nourish.
Oh god, Fandral Nourish. Fandral.
No ancient, way.
Fandral Ancient of Wars, like. Absolutely ridiculous stuff Fandral can do.
It's absolutely incredible the stuff Brandon can do.
You like this?
That's insane. What are we just doing? Brandon things.
I called hashtag. It. Like, I don't know.
This is. So what about you, Brian? What are your top three cards, man?
Number one would be Wisp of the Old Gods. No.
Man, I've seen Wisp of the Old Gods win games.
It's in the top ten.
I've seen Wisp of the Old Gods win games.
I was running it with my my early Yogg Druid deck and was actually getting some pretty sexy value out of it. The other problem is you just can't really. There's not a lot of opportunities unless you're holding on to like a you know, like an Innervate or something to really combo it with anything.
Yeah.
But man, is it pretty when you do.
Oh man. Yeah, oh dude, I saw somebody Fandral whisper Innervate whisper the old guy before. I was like, not like this. These plays are too strong.
I don't know. I think I would definitely say top card I'd probably I don't know. I have to think about this. I would definitely say second place would be I think I would probably have to agree. It's probably either Fandral or maybe Dr. Four or even Yogg.
Oh yeah, Flaming Faceless.
Yogg has opened up like a whole different style of play for certain classes.
Mm-hmm.
Like just seeing like the spell rogue and then dropping Yogg. Like even the match that we had at the what was it, the Tavern Hero when I was playing against Matt and I was so far behind. But I had like what was that, like a 22 spell Yogg.
Mm.
Just the swing that card can bring. And yeah, it's random, but it just opens up this whole set of methods to play that you're just like, oh, this is cool.
Yeah.
I would have worked out in your favor. It works out in your favor.
Speaking of Yogg, let's take a look here. Okay. Let's see what happens, shall we?
I'll say fun Yogg story.
Man.
I'll let's say fun, a fun Yamcha story was I was playing yesterday. I was playing against it was a Druid yesterday, and I would have won that game, and I was about to win the game, but he played a Yogg, and his Yogg gave him two hit me with two Mind Blasts. I had like 12 life left or something. I hit me with two Mind Blasts, and then he played played a Mage Secret and a Paladin Secret, and so I had 4 life after I armored up because I was playing Warrior, and then I had a Kirkron Elite and some other stuff, and I had no option but to go face, and that secret, the Paladin Secret, was Eye for an Eye. I died because y'all Mind Blast me twice and then played Eye for an Eye. It was the saddest loss. Oh man. And that's, I think Yogg is really powerful. He's something I didn't consider. I'm interested as to why no one said C'Thun, or like maybe Darkshire Councilman. Like,
I just hit the wrong button.
That's fine. You didn't need those 3 cards.
Probably fine.
Yeah.
Probably fine.
Yeah. I'm getting the commentary.
Damn it.
Alright, you and Brian should spectate. I guess you're probably watching the stream, but you can spectate.
I mean, the stream's gonna be delayed, so the stream's always gonna be behind the.
Yeah. Give this handlock a try.
But, yeah, dude. So, what about, C'Thun, or, you know, or, like, Darkshire Councilman, or cards like that? Nothing. Ooh, Thing from Below. Like,
yeah, I think the low would just go into my like whole shaman card, because I think shaman probably out of all the classes easily one of the best deals.
They
shaman
made it playable.
Shaman complete. Hey, you shut your mouth! I was playing shaman before all this.
No, shaman was good before.
But it has brought in a whole bunch of nice playstyle. I mean, there's so many potentially viable shaman decks, and like the control shaman style, I think is just absolutely hilarious. I think it's great.
I love it.
It may not be the powerhouse that, you know, like aggro midrange would, but it's got so much potential. And just trying to blast through those big taunts, and you just put the death rattle resummon the minion on them. It's like, oh dear lord!
Yeah, it definitely is what I would call a fun deck.
I think control shaman's Bog Shaman is actually pretty solid, and you know, because they gave him so many cards that are just so good. Like Stormcrack is such a good single target removal that it makes no sense that it has it. The fact that you can play free taunts after Totem Man for so long, it's just so much good stuff for that deck. And then the amount of value, the amount of greed that you can, you know, afford to have when you have Elemental Destruction is ridiculous. Like, just even having the ability to kill a bunch of, to know you're gonna do 4 to 5 damage to everything on the board at any given point in time is just, like, why?
Just want to point out how great Dark Peddler is for handlock.
Yeah.
Gives you a minion on the board and keeps the same number of cards in your hand.
That is true.
Dark Peddler is the best card from whatever set it was in. I don't know what it was, but
it's the best card in any set.
Whatever. I don't know about any set. That's crazy. That's crazy, man.
It's like, a pretty good card.
You're telling me that Dark Peddler is better than Dr. Boom right now. Right now, you're telling me.
It might be.
Yeah, I'm telling you that right now.
It's definitely not as impactful. Crazy. It's definitely not as impactful, right? But like,
you are.
What
Warlock deck do you not play Dark Peddler in?
That's fair. That's a good point.
Like, even an imaginary.
What deck did you not play Dr. Boom in?
Zoo?
Face Hunter? Played Dr. Dr. Boom.
Yeah, they were wrong.
They were absolutely correct. You're a madman, friend. You're a fucking madman.
They were wrong. It's fine.
You're a bad man, Brit. You're fucking crazy.
It's okay. It's okay to be wrong. Especially if you're having fun.
What about Hex, man? Like, Hex is like the best fucking removal card in this game.
Hex is good.
Oh no, man. Oh no.
I didn't want to get rid of that card.
Oh, are you sure?
I think.
Oh man. Are we sending out invitations to spectate? What?
I need help!
Anybody can spectate. I mean, it's open. As long as you're friends with me on Battle.net.
Ooh, Jay's in trouble.
I'm sure he's fine. So I definitely forgot about Shadow Flame.
Hashtag tap last.
Oh man.
Brandon, are you gonna smack me up here?
Oh yes, definitely.
That sounded way dirtier than
he's gonna smack you up with the Nard knob.
Oh god.
Please don't.
Smack him up. It was not possible for me to have killed you on that turn.
But, man. Dark Peddler. I don't know, man. I'm still trying to think. I honestly cannot disagree. I think Dark Peddler is the best Warlock card to ever come up. I can't say it's the best card, man. I just can't. Especially when we consider cards, like, that came out that were really good, like, in their peak. Like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Like what about like Unleash the Hounds before it got nerfed? Like I definitely think that card was fucking ridiculous. Or pre-nerf Edwin.
Didn't Unleash the Hounds the only nerf was it just increased the mana cost by one?
It increased the mana cost by, wasn't it two?
No, it's just one. I don't know. I feel like it was just one, but.
They nerfed it, buffed it, nerfed it so many times, dude. Like, and then, Starving Buzzard, I definitely think Starving Buzzard was good. No, sorry. You know what was the best card in any set? Warsong Commander before I got nerfed.
It technically wasn't the best card in the vanilla set and the max set.
I'm saying before it got nerfed.
Even then.
No, man, because of... Then. No, that's not true. In the vanilla set, no, because OTK Warrior used to be a thing. Because, well, Warsong Commander used to give charge to everything played after it. So people would, like, OTK with Molten Giants and, you know...
Oh, yeah. That was hilarious.
There was nothing funny about that at all. That shit hurt my soul.
So I learned recently that Shattered Sun... No, come on. There's no way you have it.
That's not even close to true. All I need is another Doomguard.
I was gonna say, but there's no way you drew all three.
Wow. I had the PO for a while. Like, you would have had to do other shit to beat a minion. Like, I would have rather had a minion than that PO.
Okay, so guys, opinion. What do you guys feel is the most improved card in Whisper of the Old Gods? A card that was out but is now seeing a lot of play where prior to this it wasn't. What card do you think got benefited from Whispers most? I think probably Nourish is one card that I can think of that got a big buff. And Argon Squires, dude. Argon Squires everywhere.
Yeah. For sure.
Argon Squires probably like one of the premier one drops.
Knife Joyguard? Doomsday?
No, seriously.
Flavor. The flavor wise. Crazed Alchemist? Because of Doomsayer?
I say Doomsayer is really good. It was a really good choice because now a lot of control decks look to Doomsayer for their early game board plays because a lot of control decks lost a lot of early game, you know, either AoE effects or single target effects in Warlock's case. So. And Kodo, now that you mentioned things that clear things, Kodo, like, really came up because of it. Yeah, man, I really like Whispers because I really like Whispers a lot. It's bringing back a bunch of old cards that didn't see. It brought to life a bunch of cards that weren't seeing play. And it psyched me out a bit because a couple cards I thought wouldn't see play actually have a pretty solid, you know, niche. And they do what they do, and they do them pretty well. Like, Faceless Manipulator, dude. Faceless Manipulator is really, really good in Whispers for some reason.
I'm just eternally sad that Yasha Raj is not better.
Listen, that's my favorite. That's my favorite old god. We had this discussion.
I know.
Yasha Raj is better on turn 4 with Barnes. I think we're going to see Yasha Raj.
It works really well in a Nivea.
Dude.
Oh my gosh.
Barnes into copy of Yasha Raj, pulling out the real Yasha Raj.
You guys are crazy. Some men just want to see the world burn. Man, I can't wait for Barnes. Barnes is probably the best card that's been revealed thus far.
I'm excited for that.
How do you guys feel about Medivh?
I
don't think he's that good.
I don't really care about him.
If there's ever a time where, like, it's just control decks, like, wailing on each other, like, hoping that they can end their life soon, it's really good in the control mirror. Like, it's unbeatable in the control mirror, unless you have a way to destroy the weapon.
That's fair. That's a good assessment. I was thinking,
If the warrior's playing Medivh, which I don't think they would, but if you brawl, does that minion get summoned before it brawls? Or, like, Nether? Does Nether destroy the minion?
I'm pretty sure it will be before it brawls.
That's how summoning works, right?
I'm gonna say, yeah, because it says when you cast the spell, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so when you cast the spell is the same text as, like, Wild Pyro.
I think it's better than Summoning Stone, but that's not saying anything.
Yeah. But at the same time, like, say for, like, Mage, it's a weapon that you're holding, and how many classes are gonna really play weapon hate, you know? How many classes are not gonna play their, Harrison Jones against the Mage on 5? You know what I mean?
Well, like, I guarantee, like, Grinder Mage list, like, Reno Mage, is definitely running that card.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I mean, I'm sure it'll see play, I think, in, like, fringe scenarios. I don't think it's gonna be, like... I don't think it's gonna be, like, game-breaking. I could see Paladin abusing it, because, dude, if you get, like, Lay on Hands into Ragnaros, you're just like, yeah.
Oh, yeah, man. Dude, those 8-mana spells.
Yeah, certain classes are gonna play that card better than others. Like, Shaman probably won't have a whole lot of reason to play it.
Yeah.
Hunter, probably not. Like, if you have... I think if you summon, like... If you're playing, like, 6 cost spells or more, I think it's okay. Like, it might actually even be okay in Priest. It might give you a reason to run Mind Control.
I was Light, man. I hate Light Bomb, and I don't want it to be a thing. But at the same time, I feel like it needs to be... It needs to exist for Priest to exist.
But, I mean, you Medivh, on turn 8... You're holding onto your entombs, like, and you entomb, like, a C'Thun or something like that. You summon a 6-cost minion. It's just, like, it might be okay. That's another card I might run in Priest, just because, why not? Experiments.
And I just don't see Medivh doing too much, but maybe, who knows? That would be actually pretty cool to see Medivh do something, So...
Other than just, you know, ruin the world.
Ruin the world?
Doing something.
Listen here. Medivh didn't ruin the world. You don't know what you're talking about.
You got me.
Medivh didn't ruin the world ruined Medivh.
Handlock couldn't beat Hunter before, and I bet it can't now.
I mean, I don't know. I think the Handlock, yeah, man.
Do we want to do a legit set? since we're at 8 o'clock, halfway mark.
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay. Yo, Brandon, you should send me an invite so I can actually commentate this game.
All right. Well.
Actually, no. We can't commentate the game because you're playing each other. We're both in the club.
I can drop out of.
Skype
phone. You can just mute. But,
I could do that. I mean, why not?
Yeah. You can just.
Commentate. Game's gonna be good enough on its own.
All right.
I mean, I could play against either one of the other guys, and Brandon, you can commentate. And...
Oh yeah, I'll just commentate on the what's actually been played. Yeah, yeah. So, you four pick who's gonna play.
I'll play somebody. If nobody's is jumping on it.
I will still play. Unless one of the other guys who hasn't played wants a chance. Alright.
Sounds like Tim and I.
Alright. First I gotta kick you from spectating so that I can actually challenge you. Alright, I am gonna mute my mic.
So you can't hear us. Mute.
Yeah. All right, give me a second. I'm gonna go ahead and just whisper Tim my list. I'm gonna bring priest instead of druid right now, I think.
Oh no, you can put the like. You guys should put on the BFG stream info what decks you're playing. Matt, you haven't given me an email address yet. Put it in the team chat.
You can also put it in Twitch chat.
I mean, you can put your email in Twitch chat if you want. I'm not going to stop you.
Hey, Tim, so I'm bringing a warrior, warlock, shaman, and priest. What are you banning?
I'll give you one guess.
Warrior.
You said warrior, warlock, shaman, priest. I'm gonna do my usual of Wartrier, Warlock. Wow, I can't type. Shaman and Mage. What are you banning?
I want to ban your Mage, actually. But. I think I'm going to ban your Warlock.
Always ban Warlock. Always forget.
Ban Warlock, man. Let him play the hammer.
Alright, let's see. Alright, let's mute Skype.
You mute.
Just go to like your sound thing.
You can still hear me.
No, I know. How do I mute? Just
open the audio mixer.
I think you can mute me. Can't you? Like make it where you can't hear.
No, I'll just mute Skype entirely.
Yeah.
Oh, I just gotta go to the sound mixer. Right. I'll be muting myself with my mic. Send me a message. Matt, I'm assuming you're doing the same.
Yeah, I think I didn't. I already send you one. Oh wait, no.
Send me what?
Sending a message of what I'm playing. Sorry, I was only like half listening.
Yeah, you were very clearly half listening. No, are you just gonna drop out of the call?
No, don't do that because it'll fuck up my.
You're right. It will.
My images. Yeah, just mute it.
All right, I'm muted from now on. Bye, guys.
Bye. Bye, Matt.
See ya.
All right. We are just waiting for them to get started. And also, Rising Blade says, "Go Matt, Tim sucks." That's important to know.
Man. Oh, wow.
Well, Tim's got his team. Matt needs matrons. Matt's... Moogles?
Let me get him to send me some.
Masters? Maesters?
We're trying to... Are we coming up with names for his fan base?
Yeah, Matt's fan base, yeah. While I set everything up.
Okay, okay.
There we go.
Isn't Matt supposed to be the one to, like, give his fan base a name? Are we stealing that from
him? I don't know, man. I don't know, man. We could. I mean,
he's getting lights out here in these streets. Check to make sure he can. There we go.
Oh, did it crash?
Oh, I cycled the card off.
Mine crashed, I guess. Thanks, Jacques.
Wait, what crashed?
My Hearthstone.
Oh, did it? Oh.
I was like, why is Tim taking so long on this turn?
Oh, yeah. No. Oh, man. So, Freeze Mage versus, getting some of his priest action.
Sorry, I'm almost done with this potato, and then I'll be right there.
Okay. Well, I'll power mention into the power shield just to clear these off board. get that nice clean board to play on this first board. Not that this really truly matters to the Freeze Mage, but this Wild Pyro is actually going to be able to start getting him some card advantage here in the next couple turns, because Tim's not going to be able to really do anything about this. Tim's not really going to be able to do with anything about either of these cards. Even if he had to burn, he would have to be reluctant to spend it, and he would most likely spend it on the cleric as opposed to the pyromancer anyway. Sorry, guys. But...
Alright. So there we go. I got his hand now and everything. He's got that all-important Justicar.
Oh, yeah. Justicar is one of the cards that wins you this matchup, honestly. Because she can keep you at such a high health total. And also, the Priest's hero power is actually... A lot of people talk about the Warrior hero power, but the Priest's hero power is pretty solid, too. It doesn't do... It kind of does the same thing, but the only difference is it doesn't go over 30. But the fact that you can, like, constantly keep yourself at higher health totals, and you can constantly out-heal the things, makes it to where the Freeze Mage has to wait longer to burst.
Yeah, that's a pretty important effect. And Tim, he's playing this Thrasian, like, right away. It's definitely...
Yeah, I'm surprised, too. Why do you think he did that? Do you think he just wanted the tempo on board? Do you think he just doesn't care about the death of the Entomb, or...? He should know this is Freeze Mage. He should know that there are no more important targets than that right now for this. Death. That's probably the most value he was going to get out of that Shadow Word Death.
Yeah, I don't.
Or that Entomb, for that matter. It's just really, it's really questionable as to why he did that, in my opinion. But Doomsayer comes down. He just wants the Doomsayer to soak 7 damage. He doesn't even actually truly care about clearing the board, because he knows he can't at the point. He already has 7 damage on the board, so he knows it's not possible. He just wants to try and soak something, but this Justicar is going to come down, and that hero power is going to get that, you know, gonna be get bumped up before healing a turn, and this is looking pretty rough for Tim. But you know, on that, on the other side of the coin, he also has his ice. He also has his ice barrier and ice block now. Ice barrier is gonna get popped.
Yeah.
Gonna go for that nice 8.
Do you see any way that Tim wins this?
I don't see a way Tim loses this.
Really?
Wait, no. Like, right now... Well, actually, yeah, I'm sorry. I was mistaken. Well, he can burn him down to 15, right? But
okay.
But the problem is, at the moment, he still has to do something about that Akanai Sulfurs. Right? Like...
Yeah, he can attack the 8-8 with it.
Oh, yeah. Wait. The Flash Heal... I didn't even notice the 2 flash heals in the back of his hand right there.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I think Tim probably loses this game now that you brought that to my attention. I'm the 2 flash heals are gonna put him way too high. But he actually runs Thalnos, so if he can find the Thalnos and some more burn, like say he can get his if he can find his Roaring Torches. I mean, Forgotten Torches. Get
yeah,
the
he has. I mean, that's like a long way away.
Yeah, but this is also, you guys gotta remember, this is Priest we're talking about here. So this game is probably gonna be grinding out for a while anyway.
Yeah.
But yeah, man, he's basically back to full, but... Oh, the greetings.
Yeah, I mean, Tim has got this. Tim has got this, you know, another ice block.
Yeah.
So, I guess, I mean, possible.
So what do you think is, if Tim's going to win, do you think it's based, it's all upon the Thalnos?
I don't think Tim's going to win. He has to deal 30 damage in one turn, so yeah, it has to be a Thalnos, right? He's out of, can he even deal 30 in one turn? Because he's got,
I don't think he can deal 30 in one turn, but
no.
What he can do is I think he can, especially since it's, his Thorsen's already been triggered, so, but what he can do is he can set up for a 2-turn win now that both flash heals are gone.
Yeah.
I think that's going to be the play. Like, he's not going to be able to kill him all in one turn, but if he can get him low enough to where he can burst burn him, I think that's going to be the play. I think that's going to be it.
Yeah, like, the setting up to get rid of Sylvanas, it's like the only threat, except, you know, his opponent can just heal it to full health. I don't know. Like, it makes his opponent heal it, but, like, he's not doing anything, so...
Yeah, I guess it's eating 2 mana.
Yeah, but you don't even care about that at this point. Like,
that's true. 2 mana is pretty, you know, expendable at this point.
Yeah. Well, you thought Flash Heal was good, but what about this 1 mana heal for 9? Do you think you just play Holy Note over here? Just, like, get the extra damage? Get the pressure going? Like, it's like a whole turn difference. I guess not. I guess that's fine.
Yeah,
steal one of the 0-2s.
I mean, not that actually the 0-2 makes that big a difference, if any.
Yeah.
He's getting these. At least he's getting these Forgotten Torches cycled and getting them developed into the Roaring Torches. So let's say, like, what's the most damage he can do over the course of a couple turns? Let's see. With the Forgotten Torches, like, say, let's say he has the Roaring Torches, he can do like. What, 3 fireballs? I think he has a frostbolt, that's 1. So 3 fireballs, that's 18. Frostbolt 21, and then 2 ice lances. So that's, 29?
Yeah, so if he draws the,
If he draws both Roaring Torches, he needs both.
Yeah.
He can burst him from 29 health. But if he gets to Thalnos, he can do a decent amount of damage too. Because let's see, Fireball with the Thalnos is 8 plus. Oops, oh, I'm tripping. I gave.
Just add Thalnos at the end. It's like 9 plus 8 is 17 plus 4 is 21. So that's not. If he. He's nowhere near enough damage. Like.
Yeah.
Has Matt played both Doomsayers yet? Or not both Doomsayers, whatever it's called. Akanai Soul Priest, that's the one.
He only played one.
Because Tim is keeping his ice block up. Like, his last turn he didn't necessarily need to freeze because he had the ice block, but I guess he was keeping it up to play around the Akanai.
Mm-hmm. Super Shades coming down over there. Which one would you take? Skeleton Knight, probably? But no.
Yeah, for sure.
You take Skeleton Knight?
Yeah, because Tim doesn't have his expensive minion anymore.
Well, so, yeah, like, and actually, Skeleton Knight's going to come back. That's true.
And it comes back off. Come back.
Oh, go ahead.
Yeah, well, no, you were going to say it, too. You can go ahead.
Oh, yeah. I was just going to say it comes back off Enzo. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's actually really a good reason. Oh, here goes the Roaring Torch 1. He can still do this.
he has to draw Roaring Torch. And that's gonna be hilarious.
If he draws Roaring Torch right now, oh my goodness. Still alive. The dream. Is it?
No.
We glitched. Not like
you
this.
You glitched? You can't see what's going on? He drew Blizzard. He played it. So Tim's out 11. Troy's out 11.
Oh, man.
He did draw Akanai, though, so he won. Because he can just heal Tim down to 0.
Oh, did Tim not play his other ice block this turn?
No, he played the Blizzard instead. I think that was a mistake, but I'm not real. I mean, he was probably gonna lose anyway.
Man, but what if he didn't? What if he drew the Novice Engineer?
Matt would have had to decide to not heal his face. If he would have won that turn, yeah, that would have been hilarious. For real. That would have been hilarious.
Man, that would have been, that would have been so good. Oh man, I didn't know I could like do my watch and learn quest from watching friends play games.
Yeah, they changed it.
Oh, what?
Yeah, remember when they did like that? You can now get your quests against friends.
I thought it was only one quest that gave you 80 gold.
No, you can get any quest against your friends now. They just have to not concede, or you have to not concede, pending.
Hmm.
Yeah, it's nice, because it's like, yeah, people are going to cheat, but, you know, at the same time, like, it really rewards the non-cheaters, so, like, you know.
Yeah.
And that's what you're, that, you know. That's who you really care about, right? So.
Oh wow, you don't even need to get an invite from people to just like spectate both now?
Right, yeah.
Oh, I thought you had to get an invite.
They have to accept you. But.
Oh, this is a. Ends off a lot?
I guess, yeah. It's really deadlock. Yeah, that's it. That's game. Yeah, and he knows.
Definitely turn four lock right there.
He knows. That's awesome.
And then the mystery card that Tim drew, I will never know what it is.
It was a Ravaging Ghoul. It was pretty good. Pretty good in that situation.
Man, that is crazy. That was a super fast game. Four turns, and that's it.
Yeah.
Seven, so six. 1-1.
Yep. Let me update the score.
So, I think that if he's playing Inzoth block, Tim should probably try and get the Freeze Mage in against the Inzoth block. Even though, but to be fair, that game went so fast, Tim doesn't know it.
Yeah, that's true. He doesn't know if it's hand block or whatever. I mean, he sort of does, because he knows what Matt's playing, but...
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's, you know, he technically might not know.
Yeah. This is a strategic Ooh. And both get the Arden Squire lead off. So.
Yeah. It's a good start. It's also the best answer to Arden Squire is Arden Squire.
Blood to Ichor.
Blood to Ichor? Yeah, Blood to Ichor, actually. That's better.
I hate when that happens to me on turn one. Like, I play my Argent Squire, my opponent Blood to Ichor, my Argent Squire is Divine Shield. Oh man, it's so rough.
That does sound rough.
So, do you totem or do you trog?
I think you totem, but like, you definitely, like, it's only because you have the flame time.
Okay.
Like,
that makes sense.
Because if you don't trog, he could just get way too far ahead by, like, mm-hmm. you know, playing his whatever, the totem goal. But, yeah.
Ooh. Yeah. I'll totem. It's a good totem.
Is it? Is it a good totem?
Stone Claw? I love Stone Claw.
Yeah. That was. I was trying to be a little funny.
I know what you're saying. I know what you're doing. I'm just not letting you do it.
Yeah. You succeeded. So then I like this play a lot.
Oh yeah. This is definitely the correct play. Keep all your minions at full health. Only thing is, he has that storm. Do you just play the Tuskar? Are you in a bad enough position to where you think you stormed this early, or do you feel like Tuskar is better?
Tuskar seems terrible here because, like...
Oh yeah, and he gets punished for this.
Well, no, he's gonna... He's gonna rock back down to 0-3. That's...
Yeah.
So, he's fine. Like... Yeah, he's golden. Well then.
Yeah, because now his boy can't... Well, totem golems... You get to change that.
It's pretty sweet.
You get the totem golem, you can,
But I like this play too, because it's still, like, making your opponent trade 2-for-1. Keeping your advantages, setting up your Doomhammer on the next turn. Like, if you play totem golem, you can't Doomhammer, so...
True, you can't Doomhammer next turn.
I mean, you'd be fine.
Would have like a 1 mana. Wouldn't you have? I think it was a 3 mana thing from below, right?
Right. So next turn you would have been able to play Tuskar, Totemic, and thing from below.
Mm-hmm.
That's
what I was thinking. I was just thinking about clearing the Tuskar, because if he could play around Lightning Storm a bit that way.
Mm-hmm.
It plays around Lightning Storm a bit, and then you would have your thing from below still pretty healthy and ready to go. But he had the hex anyway, so it didn't really make a difference. Yeah. Now he gets the Doomhammer.
I like to set up the best card in your deck. Because he doesn't... Like, nobody's really playing like Swampoon, so he knows that he doesn't have an answer to the Doomhammer, and at the very least, like, it's gonna take something plus to deal with like this. Now he's attacking him on two fronts, like the weapon and the board. So, you know, he's set.
That definitely makes sense. That's I like that play better now, don't you? We talked it up. So you can deal with this multiple ways.
Yeah.
But just lava burst it?
I don't think so, because I think what I would want to do is I want to play. I want to play Totem Golem because I want to kill my opponent faster. But I think this. I'm actually. Ooh, I don't like that placement. But ends up not mattering.
Yeah, that.
But
man, wow, that does work.
That's really good. It worked out really well. So this gives him 6 mana next turn. But what you really wanted was at least that 5 mana next turn, because he has, you know, he has 11 damage on board, and. Mm-hmm. If his opponent did nothing, which he's obviously not going to do nothing. Like it's 6 mana. It's oh what? Wow, he's just going for the greedy play here.
I think he's really far behind. He kind of.
He kind of got to go for it.
Pull it up.
Oh, and yep, he's going to lose. So.
Oh wow.
There it is.
Yeah, that's rough. That's game.
Yep. He does not need the totem goal.
Disrespectful. The disrespect. Total yep. Golem.
Alright, so we've got 2-1.
Freeze Mage versus the world.
Yep, he's got to win a game with Freeze Mage. We'll see if it can happen.
So, how, in your experience, I don't know how many people have been playing against Freeze Mage, but how do you feel aggro shaman plays against Freeze Mage? Does it do pretty well now?
Burn has always been good against Freeze Mage, you know, and so have weapons. So Shaman's set up well. They just don't have the Hunter Hero power to be, you know, experts against it. But it's fine.
Okay.
It's just fine.
Oh yeah, Tim gets a good hand. If this was Zoo, this would be a good solid hand versus Zoo.
I mean, it's a good hand here too, you know. It's like,
what with all the, but with the death, since this is a death rattle deck, I mean, you know, Doomsayer kind of loses a bit of its value.
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
Just a little bit though. Like, it's not like horrible. Yeah, he's gonna ping that. There's no reason to do anything else. Everything else is pretty bad. I think he's going to drop the Doomsayer this turn, right? I think Doomsayer comes down this turn to not only get rid of the Imp King boss, but also to contest potential for the plays the next turn and give Tim a free board to work with. Or he could just, you know, cycle the Arcane Intellect because it's not that much damage. He decides to go with the intellect play.
I like playing the Doomsayer there because turn 4 is, that's Drake. You know what I mean? Like that's
true.
You know. Oh, he doesn't even play it. Interesting. So maybe I know less about what Matt's trying to do with this deck.
No. Matt has it right there. It's Azure, I mean, the
project's
right in his hand, right there.
Right, what I'm saying is he didn't play it though.
Oh, okay.
Like, I thought for sure he would have slammed it.
I was thinking the same thing, like, and that's one of the reasons that I was pretty surprised that Tim didn't drop that on 3, but, and he also gave him an extra chance to draw into something that could potentially deal with the Doomsayer, so.
There's nothing that, like, scary about it. There's no, like, amazing way in a deck like this to deal with, I guess, the silence, maybe, but.
Oh, yeah, man. I didn't even notice the Spellbreaker.
He just drew it. He didn't have the mana for it, so. But, like, yeah, I mean, I didn't even think about that, but that's, that would definitely have been something to be afraid of.
Yeah. Spellbreaker would have been... If he would have had Spellbreaker, man, he would have been pushing kind of far ahead now.
Yeah, for sure.
Fucking intellect. And I think he's doing that just so he can get the ice block down. Yeah, I guess that was the play. I think he's going to do it either for the ice block or for the Forgotten Torch. But I guess Forgotten Torch is... The first Forgotten Torch is actually minion. This is gonna get pretty nasty. All that value from hand. He's gonna have to fireball that. There's no way around it. You can't let that many cards get produced twice.
Yeah, and I think fireballing this is okay. Like, you do have other options with like the there's other ways to kill it, but.
What other way do you see to kill it?
Oh, never mind. I thought he had one more mana than he did. I thought you could have Blood Mage, Thalnost, into Forgotten Torch, into Hero Power. But
yeah.
Nope, he did not have enough mana for that. So.
Well, I guess he could have Thalnost, Frostbolted, and King. If he wanted to take a similar route, but... Tim is in an actually decent position if only he can find his Emperor.
Yeah, he definitely is going to need that.
If he finds Emperor, like, relatively soon, Tim is going to be set. Get the Ice Barrier up. I need to get the Ice Barrier up this early. I probably would have played the Acolyte, but I guess the Acolyte gets dealt with pretty easily. I just didn't see a reason to play the barrier. Like, I don't see why he felt the need to have to play the barrier now.
I don't think, like, he was feeling pressured or anything. Like, I don't think he's responding to anything necessarily.
Well, I guess actually, no. He couldn't have played. I guess, after counting the cards, he could have made him mill a card if he wanted to, but that would have. I don't think that would have been worth it to make him mill one card. Because if he would have attacked with the slime and then attacked with the Twilight Drake into the Acolyte, it would have filled his hand, and then he would have milled one the next on his following draw. But I don't think that would have been worth it.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, I don't think so.
Okay. Ping. Searching for his other Doomsayer. Okay. Frostnova. That's good. Call the board. Tim's actually in a pretty good position right now. If his opponent's not willing to do anything, he's going to get the full three draws off this Acolyte because he's going to ping it again next turn.
Right. Unless he draws a Doomsayer. Do you think he plays that combo?
I think he could. He also has the option of, like, Alexing, but he's not gonna. Well, I guess he's not gonna kill him anyway. So the Alex is kind of out. Alex is just gonna have to sit there and wait for a second. Yeah, I think that's a good idea. Also, if he picks up a Doomsayer, go ahead and get that board clear, and get that eight health back from that Corrupted Healbot. Ooh, nice Spellbreaker. Spellbreaker shut down that card draw.
That's pretty funny. Well, that's enough to kill, right? Isn't it? Because it's 7 plus 6 plus
3?
I mean, that's enough, but...
Yeah, that's... isn't it like 1 over?
Yeah, but if his opponent heals, then he's kind of screwed. So I think he's just going to play conservatively.
Yeah.
Which is interesting, but he can do it, so... I mean, you know, his opponent doesn't have any ways to just, like, deal direct damage, and his opponent doesn't have many ways, sorry. So he has Hellfire and Peddler into Soulfire, like, those are the things, because we've seen Hellfire, and he's got to be playing Peddler, so it's not... Like, I'm playing around that because he's got so many cards in his hand. But if you can, you know, stay above, which he won't be able to have a high life total if, you know, if this stuff is getting blocked. So, and yeah, he has Soulfire in his hand actually, so he's just playing Soulfire main deck.
Mm-hmm.
So, I was kind of rambling there without making a really like a good point, but.
No. You were. No, I.
Yeah, Matt almost played that Stampeding Kodo, and he said, "No, you know what? I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna save it for this, for a Doomsayer." And that's something another card he wanted to see burn, but.
Yeah, man, that Forgotten Torch hurts.
Yeah, it looks like Matt is definitely gonna play this Doomsayer, and it's gonna get Stampeding Kodo'd. Tim's gonna play a Doomsayer and is gonna get Stampeding Kodo'd.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Matt is excited for the Stampeding Kodo, like you can see. Like, he was hovering over it as soon as that card was played.
Yeah, man, he's trying to play it on his turn, like, goodness gracious.
Man.
So, this is definitely a good Kodo, though. Only thing that Matt doesn't know is this is also going to flip into a good Flame Strike.
Yeah.
This is going to flip into a pretty decent Flame Strike here.
He might not play, though. He might play the Alexstrasza, right? Like,
does he have the burn to make it worth it to play the Alex, though?
Yeah, he can win. If his opponent doesn't heal, he can just play Alex.
True. Oh, yeah, that's right. He can.
Oh, looks like
if he plays Alex, then he would have to play Thalnos, right?
Yeah, on the next turn.
He has to play a Thalnos burn.
Yeah, but that still doesn't even use all his mana.
I wonder what Tim keeps waiting for to get the Alex down. Maybe he's concerned about his opponent's heals. Like, even those are pretty limited. And even if that is the case, you still have like ice blocks and stuff. You still have your other ice block in hand.
Just like playing around Reno or something. I mean,
that's the only thing I can think of is he's like trying to play. He's expecting Reno.
Tim hasn't seen two ups, and he's seen a couple pretty bad cards. So, I mean, he can just play Flame Strike because it's gonna buy him like a million turns. But
yeah, but he could definitely just start ending this game whenever he wants.
Does he just like want to like make him play this in Zoth here? That could be a possibility too.
I have no idea because if he plays the Inzoth, like, what's the? I don't know. Like, what is he baiting the Inzoth for? I guess would be my question.
Right.
You know, now he should definitely get the Alex out. He already has the ice block up. There's nothing to worry about. I'm definitely thinking we go Alex this turn.
And he
unless
can...
that's what's man. That game? Let's see.
No, it's close. Because we've got 11.
6, 9, yeah.
17. Six, nine. Oh, wait. Yeah.
It's 17, you're right. Yeah. 17, and then plus 4, 21.
Yeah, it's not enough.
Wait, no, am I miscounting?
It's 10 mana. 1, 2, 10 3, mana. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mana.
Is that, and that's including the... I think I'm missing the second Frostbolt. Am I?
Well, he can't play both Frostbolts and the Roaring Torch.
Oh, yeah. You're right.
So. Man, he's just gonna wait the turn and... Man.
I don't understand why Alex has not been played yet.
Yeah.
He's definitely afraid of Reno. I think that's gotta be... That's the only call, right? Like, that's the only reason why you haven't played it.
Something like that.
I just can't think of what else you could possibly be waiting for. Because this game should have been ended like a couple turns ago. But
I mean, he's absolutely thinking about Reno. I think he's playing around Reno incorrectly, but that's absolutely what he's thinking about.
Yeah, and now, he's going to play. He's going to get the card, huh? And,
He's got to do it, right? What is
it? Yeah, I feel like he could, like, what is left to wait for at this point? See, watch the set. We're saying this now, and then like the second Tim plays it, Reno's gonna pop up.
Yeah, right.
Everybody's gonna be rich. Just don't know.
We might have to watch another game of Freeze Mage. If Tim doesn't win, we have to watch another game of Freeze Mage.
I'm probably fine with that. I mean, I love Freeze Mage, man, but I think it's really cool to watch, but it's not my solid play, so I don't really excel. I don't really excel at it, but I think it's cool.
Yeah.
Man, I don't know. What's the... You just gotta play the Alex. Like, I believe he's just waiting. If he finds the Reno, like, it's too late. I think he has to. Oh, yeah, he has to tap for it, doesn't he?
Yeah, yeah. He definitely has to tap. He's just going to gain the 3 health, though. He's going to lose.
I don't agree with that.
I mean, he might not have Reno in his deck, right? Do we know? But, like, he should. He's playing a lot of bad cards.
I thought that's what he said. I thought that's what he was
talking about earlier. Yeah. I might have missed that one.
I thought he said it, but I could be mistaken as well. Yeah. I just don't understand what Tim was so afraid of. I guess, yeah, it had to be the Reno, but it doesn't matter now.
Yeah,
it's Brian. It's a game. Yeah.
To be fair, Tim wasn't beating a Reno, though. Like,
yeah, no.
That was my problem, was that Tim wasn't beating a Reno. So, we actually miscounted. Tim had 2 more damage, so he had 23 damage. So, yeah, I mean, oh no, he didn't. Never mind. God.
I thought it was
21. Yeah, it was 21. It was 21. Okay.
Someone say 21 pilots. Because I hope not.
No.
We're
talking about 21 a lot. That's Tim's. Tim made a clever joke.
I was talking about 21 guns.
21 guns.
Alright.
I had some counting problems that game.
You sure did.
I mean, okay, so why were you not playing the Alex? Was it just because you were really worried about Reno coming down and you not being able to win through Reno, or?
I figured if I didn't have Emperor in, like, the bottom 3 cards of my deck, I would just Emperor, you know, have him pop the Ice Block, Emperor, or Ice Block again. And if he, I would have, like, an insane amount of damage with Thalnos.
Yeah.
And, like, the 5 spells.
So, yeah. Here's
Plenty
the deal.
Of time.
You were playing around Reno, and the only way you could beat Reno was if you drew Emperor Thrasian. Mm-hmm. So, you know, we're gonna have this game on in the background. So the only way that you could beat the full heal was if you drew Thrasian, and I just, like, I don't know, man. I wouldn't have played around it. Wouldn't have thought that I was gonna. I wouldn't have counted on me drawing Thrasian. I would have just played the
Alex
right away, basically.
That's what I was thinking.
That's one of those situations where you're putting yourself in a do or die situation that early on in the game when you don't need to do that. You can just wait it out and then find, you know.
No, that's what I'm. That's what I'm trying to tell you is that, like, you're gonna lose eventually. But you're trying to tell me that you're not going to lose eventually.
No, I'm saying I will lose eventually, but I've got more time before that happens. More time to draw cards, more time to find it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I guess that's fair. You know, I guess my thing was, if he had it, I feel like you were putting him in positions where he had to have played it sooner or later. So, I feel like he couldn't afford to keep taking the pings, and he couldn't afford to keep doing the stuff he was doing.
I mean, it wasn't... It wasn't, like, super cut and dry or whatever, but...
Yeah. No. I would never, you know, say something, buy something like that, yeah.
Also, the more time I bought for him to fill up his port, the easier it would be for me to burn him down. Because he already used... I think he already used a Mortal Coil. He would have to use, like, a Shadow Bolt to kill his own minion and then Reno, which... is totally possible, but...
I actually had Shadow Flame in hand. There's a reason that turn took forever. Yeah. I was like, well...
yeah.
I have to actually come back in here because my thing glitched. Because, oh, we got shut down.
All I gotta say about Freeze Mage, fun and interactive.
All I gotta say about Matt, whiny as hell.
Oh!
Oh, shots fired. I'm just kidding, I love you, buddy.
Matt's laugh was like, I don't believe you.
Freeze Mage, man. Freeze Mage is one of those decks where it's... I respect... Especially now, like, there's no question now. Freeze Mage takes, like, a lot of skill.
It takes a lot of guts to play it right now in this meta.
Oh, no, man. A lot of guts to just freeze everything and...
Also takes a lot of patience.
Yeah, it takes both.
Yeah, it does.
Dude, when you lose to Warriors, Aggro Shaman, Reno Lock, Yogg Druid...
Are you just naming a bunch of, like, Tier 1 and Tier 1.5 decks?
Yeah. 90% of the decks out there, except for Zoo. You're gonna have a bad time.
Does it lose to Yogg Druid?
With Feral Rage in Raven Idols, yeah.
Yeah, because it can just pick armor cards.
What is this madness? Wait, why must you...
Did I just get owned? Looks like I just got owned.
What are these lonely squires doing?
I don't have any cards in my hand.
Yeah, I'm feeling okay, but, like, also, like, kinda nervous.
I think there's a card in my deck that can win me this game.
Interesting.
That sounds okay.
You know what I gotta say to that card?
Oh, here it comes. He's got the Twilight Guardian.
That belongs in a museum.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, God, no.
Can I draw my second one, please?
I'm okay with that.
I don't even know if I run two. It's the first time I've ever played this deck.
What is this? Is this like aggro mage?
Does oil wins, doesn't it? Or is that only +3?
Oil is not in anymore. It was beating some ass.
Yeah.
Don't give me that.
Yeah.
Wait. Is this what you've been climbing with this season?
No. I've been playing with the Pirate Warrior.
Oh, shit. How's that been going? I mean, you seem like you've been destroying ranks.
Very quickly. And it's a nice change of pace from Dragon Warrior, because you're just like, oh no, I'll just, I'm starting to lose this game. You got big taunts in the way, I'll just start using my weapons to reduce my health low enough to mortal strike you for 6 damage. And that's how you win games.
Yeah. That's, mortal strike for 6 damage was back, I remember. So Andre made that, super low budget aggro warrior back in the day. Yep. I think it was before any expansion. And,
wow. I'm pretty sure all of us have played that.
That deck was awesome.
Yeah, it was.
This Buccaneer.
Never lucky.
Oh,
never lucky.
Get away from Bucky the Buccaneer. Yes, Tim, I named the Buccaneer.
Bucky the Buccaneer.
Oh man, this is beautiful.
Okay, so I have a a quibble about Eaglehorn Bow, and I don't know if anybody else has ever mentioned this, so I'm sorry if somebody else has mentioned this, but...
The word quibble? No, I don't think anyone has ever mentioned that. Sorry, go on.
So, the bow, right? So he's knocking the bow with his right hand, but he's like the thing that you would knock it on and like have the support the weight of the arrow, like why it's not going to support the weight of the arrow? It's above the arrow. Like
is that in the left? Is that the card on your left hand?
The one that I keep hovering over. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was thinking about playing it too.
I couldn't. I had no idea.
I decided no.
Here's what we're gonna do. I'm not gonna like it.
Ooh, excellent. I'm liking it. I'm definitely liking it. Ooh.
I don't think it. That feels so weird. When you have sources of 4 damage, 2 sources of 4 damage to kill a 5 health minion.
Yeah, that was excellent.
Oh, God.
That was bad.
Oh, Eaglehorn.
I'm so happy.
Best part about Eaglehorn Bow is the animation isn't even him, like... shooting an arrow at you. It's him whack, like, smashing the bow.
I don't even see a string. He's not pulling it back on anything.
It's an arcane string. Come on, man. Everything.
Sorry, I didn't realize that, Bone Skull Bow was, Thoradol.
Fucking nerds.
This guy.
Oh, I got owned. Holy shit.
I like this.
God. So owned.
Oh, man. Oh, aggro rogue, new meta.
I was gonna play Assassin's Blade that turn and just let you
can't play Microsoft
let you freeze him and top deck yet another one.
It might not be on Windows 10.
It better fucking be on Windows 10, because I don't know how I'm gonna fucking
hold up one sec. Type in Cortana, type paint.
Oh, okay. Whose list is this?
Oh, Windows
Extensions. It was on the competitive Hearthstone subreddit.
You found it?
Yes.
Okay.
Only
what the fuck
else
are you doing with Microsoft?
Man, I don't believe in this deck. I don't have faith.
I
mean, it almost wrecked him the first game, and it, the second game. What can a hunter do?
Yeah, can play one spell a turn. That's what hunter does. It does the best.
Even with that horribly inefficient use of my, resources.
Well, thank you, Brising Blade. You know, it's just a reference point. It's fine.
Have you never read Aragon?
No, I've not read Aragon. Is that the dragon book?
For Singer, X Blade. X. Thanks, Gib.
See, don't you ever question Wow's continuity. Hell is wrong with you.
Continuity. Oh, we're playing again. My bad.
I mean, yeah, we got one last one.
You're right. My bad.
What happened now?
Tim wasn't clicking the play button.
Mm-hmm. God damn it, Tim.
Play button, boy.
Wah!
Actually, Flame Juggler is like an insane card against you.
How do you know I didn't switch to Miracle?
I mean, you know.
That's against the rules, Tim. Conquest. Tim out here cheating in Conquest for that. Switching decks and shit.
Tim needs to cheat in order to win.
Tim, please. Only thing that you do that's close to cheating is you just quick freeze page.
You want to know how correct that felt?
Is the answer sort of correct?
It's up there.
Alright.
You want to know how good this feels?
Probably awesome.
Probably great.
Yeah, that feels good. Oh, man.
Can we get some feels good man in the chat?
Yeah.
Never mind, I'll do it.
You know how I feel about the memes.
You said 50%.
50%. Look, it doesn't even make the emoticon. That's excellent.
That's because you don't.
Get trolled, Tim. Get trolled.
Are you okay, Tim?
You probably don't even know where it comes from, do you?
Nope.
That's right.
Oh, God.
Use your lightning storm.
Come on.
Don't worry, Tim. He's not
big money. Big money. Ah.
Not a netizen like us, Tim. He doesn't understand all that stuff.
Ooh. Oh.
Holy crap. That's...
That is a weapon.
I care about you. Oh, God. Yeah, that's correct. Because you're going to lose if I draw Lightning Storm, so... Actually, no, you're not. You're going to win anyway.
You're going to win regardless.
Alright. Look at that.
Fire,
I'm going to draw Lightning Storm. Nope.
Did you draw Prep Lightning Storm?
No. Oh, God. Could you imagine how bad you would have lost? No, it's fine. Like, I'm only 50 to 60% or something to draw it.
Imagine if, imagine if Shaman had prep.
Yeah. Not into that.
That's not the kind of world I want to live in.
Prep Farsights. Hmm.
Prep Farsights. Yep. That's an efficient use of resources. Your prep permanently affects the next card you draw.
Mm-hmm.
That's so weird.
Or you could, like, prep Lightning Storms. Mm. Mm. Think about it. Prep Ancestral Spirits.
Mm. Oh, what about that?
Hey, girl, I got the shit.
What would even do anything in Shaman? Like, it would be a freaking bad.
Are you serious? Azure Drake prep Lightning Storm?
That'd be terrible. What are you talking about?
What? Terrible.
Nobody would play that shit. What are you saying? No, I'm playing that.
Alright.
Man. I can't believe how good of a Shaman draw I had, but how bad it was against that. Like, for
doesn't
real.
Doesn't that always feel terrible? Like, you're like, yeah, man, I'm going to this game with a good hand. This is going to be amazing. And then you just get waxed.
Yep.
Because your opponent's hand was bad.
This deck doesn't even play saps, I don't think.
Oh, what?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
How do you push through taunts? I don't understand.
You Divine Shield deck, Cold Blood.
Yeah, this deck also plays Pit Snake.
Does it really?
I guess so.
God, that is spicy.
I'm impressed.
That is deep. Like,
that is deep. That's some next level. That's some next level.
Okay, Sap has to be better than Pit Snake, for real though.
Yeah, I think it does. Although, I gotta agree with a lot of people. Lowly Squire is fantastic in, like, an early game tempo rogue deck.
Sure. It's no Buccaneer.
But no, it's not a...
It works well with Buccaneer, that's for sure.
Yeah, it does.
Did you play in any other, like, early game type deck? Or just...
No. No.
Okay. Yeah.
I would never...
voices.
First I looked at it, I thought, I glanced at it, I was like, is that a goddamn Lance Carrier and Maid? And I was like, that's a Lowly Squire, that's even worse.
Times.
Dude, I was definitely afraid. I mean, that's what it is.
Didn't even get to show you the power of the Silithid Swarmers.
What are those? Are those
three
ambush?
Mana. 3 mana, 3/5 can only attack if you're
Wow.
Although I kind of want to play Jungle Panthers instead.
I mean, Jungle Panthers do also. Like, if your deck loses to Lightning Storm, it might as well lose hard to Lightning Storm / Consecrate. Right?
That's true.
Like, or Hellfire, Demon Wrath. Might as well lose hard. Although I feel like the deck is probably fine against Handlock. Like, can...
I bet it destroys Handlock. Okay. What's a Handlock going to do against a 5-1 Argent Squire? Siphon Soul it.
Oh, wouldn't that be the best feeling?
Oh, man.
Hellfire, Mortal Coil.
Don't talk about Handlock like that. It's just in my...
Oh, man. Alright, dudes. I'm going to call it so that I can upload the stream to YouTube before I go to bed, so.
Alright, man.
See you guys. Have fun. Thanks for coming by, everyone. Wave to the camera, guys.
Alright,
bye.
I do it once.
Yay! Thanks, Brian. Matt's waving at the camera, too. Bye, everyone.
Yeah, see you later, guys.